Hi everyone, and welcome back to my March Madness giveaway. I was really inspired to make this. It's kind of a birthday, happy birthday notice. And if you can see here, she's got little tags made here, and her mom's birthday is on the 11th of the 10th. And so you just keep changing the tags and moving in front the person's birthday so you don't forget birthdays, and it just hangs on your wall, and I just thought it was kind of cool. So I'll show you what I came up with. First of all, my inspiration for making these was these really cool knobs I got at the drawer pulls, and I got them at I think it was at Winners, and they were so cheap. It was like $2.99 for four of them. And I thought, what can I use these for? So I thought that would be a great idea because that's what they had. So I headed over to my trusty dollar store, and I found wooden plaques that look like this. And they had that nice oval shape already. I got my husband to drill a hole right here for the knob. And then first thing I did was I unscrewed the handle so it wouldn't get covered in paint or anything. And then I just started coating it with a whole bunch of off-whites and beiges and just distressing it for however you want it to look and sanding it. And just, I can't even begin to tell you what I did because I was just working as I go and it just got all wrecked. Not wrecked, distressed. And I'll show you what it looks like in a second. And then instead of having happy birthday, I punched out of my Cricut, so the cartridge I used was Georgian Basic Shapes, which was the cartridge that came with my Cricut when I got my Cricut. And on page 125, I used It's Your Day, and I cut it out at 4 inches, and that's what I came up with. So I want to show you how the finished, not finished, but where I'm at with this. So that's how it started off. So this is the stage with which mine is at now. So It's Your Day. I just glued it down with a two-way glue pen and screwed in the knob there. There's a bit that hangs off on the end, but I'm just going to get my husband to saw that little piece off there so it doesn't poke into the wall. Now for me, I did not want a birthday reminder type thing. I thought I would use this as a perpetual calendar. So when I look in the calendar, what day is it? It's the 8th or the 9th or whatever. So I created my tags using some craft cardstock, this tag stamp by Stampin' Up. They started off looking like this, very plain and simple. I took a number stamp set and numbered them from 1 to 31, and I put 1 on this side, 2 on this side. Then I put 6-inch of ribbon, glued it down inside, and put ATG tape and pulled it like that. And I ended up with, this is the type of ribbon I used. Just that skinny, skinny ribbon. I used brown. And sealed it together. And I ended up with tags that look like this. I had a little bit longer loop, but it was too long. So all 31 tags, which really is all 16 tags to get all of them on, are here. And it's very easy to flip over for the next day, and you know it's the second. So what I'm making is a perpetual calendar. That way you could use it all the time. So this is where I'm at with the project right now. Now the other day I got Christine, who is, I think it's Cabot's YouTube user, on YouTube. She sent me this really, really pretty silk rope, and this was the label on it. And I just love the label. So what I'm going to do is Mod Podge it onto as a little bit of a background onto the back of this. I found this just so plain and just needs a little bit of sprucing up. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of create a bit of a collage with this really cool label. And I think I'm just going to tear. I'm not even going to use scissors because then it loses that cool look to it. So just, and this is really neat paper. It's very much like lunch bag paper. that they use, so I just might put a little bit over here, like so. I just want it very random. And I love the, see the script? It says Belding Corticelli. Very neat. I'm just going to take some Mod Podge and adhere these down randomly on this block. Okay, so I applied my Mod Podge text there, as you can see. I inked around the text, I wrinkled it up, and then I used brush corduroy distress ink all around, and then I brushed a little bit of that also on the board. And then you can see I put some up in that corner. And then just down here, wrapping it over the edges. And same with this one, wrapping it over the edges. So it's going to give it a little bit more zip. Next thing I'm going to do is add some pretty flowers. So I've got these roses right here. And I am going to ink them up and give them a little bit of color first. Now, I have my Perfect Pearls, Perfect Copper, because I'm trying to keep this in really neutral tones, because I've got a lot of black and brown on it. But my sprayer doesn't really seem to want to work on this. So I thought, do not despair. I just got a little bit of a finer paintbrush, and I will take the lid off, and I will brush up my flowers with just a tiny bit of this. I'll make it darker in the center, and then just brush the outside, almost like you're inking up, your scrapbook pages, and you can open the flowers up and try and put some on all the petals. And they're bigger roses, as you can see. These are the little ones, and there's the bigger size. So I'm using 3 of each. I'm going to take some brush corduroy ink, just with a makeup sponge, and then just kind of grunge up these roses as well. So they'll have a little bit of the copper and a little bit of the brushed corduroy, kind of like that. But don't be afraid to use your fingers to sort of mush it all in. And then I've got some tiny little brown roses as well. And then I have these were little yellow ones, and I did the exact same thing to them. The same treatment exactly. Then I took my Sizzix Little Leaves die. I think it's called Little Leaves. Yeah. And I cut out 2 sets. So one going one way, one going the opposite direction. And they first look like this. I just used some scrap paper that I had, and it's quite bright. So, of course, I wanted to distress it. So what I did is, this is going to be the right side. So I folded the crease down this way, down the middle of each leaf. So it's going down like that. And then opened it up. And then when you take the brush corduroy and rub it over top of that crease, it gives the semblance of a vein in the flower, and it really stands out better. And then I just ran over it a little bit of leftover Perfect Pearls, Perfect Copper, just to highlight the leaves a little bit and just give them a little bit of age, so you can see that. So I'm about to put this on the front of my plaque. So what I also did off camera is just put 1 coat of Mod Podge all over this, just to give it that nice, I love that finish, and I always use the matte finish on Mod Podge. So what I'm going to do is just arrange my flowers. This one will go kind of like that. Not even sure how much of the leaf is going to show, but it just needed a little bit of color, I felt. So I'm going to have 1 big rose and the 3 little guys around it. And then tucked in between those will be 1 of the chocolate roses and this little golden one. So maybe 1 right there. Sort of. It's kind of hard because this is tipped that way. And then a little brown one like that. So I think I'll have that little grouping there. And then do the same thing over here. So I'm just going to go ahead and finish that right now. So here is how my perpetual calendar looks. So I just have the days of the month there. So I'm not sure what day it'll be before when you'll see this. So I just left it on the first of the month. But you can easily remove the tags and change the dates and so on and so forth. So a closer look, there are the flowers in that corner and the leaves and the text behind. In the words, it's your day. You can put whatever you want, obviously, on it. And then the roses in that corner there and the text. So I think that turned out really, really, really cool. So that's going to be my giveaway number 3. So I'll show you what will be included in that giveaway. So first of all will be this plain wooden plaque, and my husband already drilled the hole there for the knob, and this one is right in the center. The one that I did before, it was a little bit off to the center, although I'm not sure if you can really tell that much, but this one's right in the center. So there's your plaque ready for hanging, and then you will also get one of the knobs here. And it has all the screws and the washers and everything on the back of it. They're so cool. You will get all of the calendar letters already stamped from 1 to 31. There you go. You will get the It's Your Day, already cut out in black. And then all this chocolate brown ribbon. And so you'll have to embellish it yourself with your own flowers. And so because I know everyone's taste is different, and these were quite neutral, so I thought they would probably go. And so, yeah, that's prize number 3. So remember, in order to be eligible for the grand prize for all the items, which so far we have the little card holder gift tin with the cards inside. We have the Making Memories Vintage Groove Jewelry Set. And we have this Perpetual Calendar Kit. So, in order to qualify for the grand prize, which includes all those items, please first leave a comment in the down bar below of this video and each one of the videos in this March Madness series. Subscribe to my channel if you don't already, and follow me on my blog if you don't already, and the link to the blog will be in the down bar as well. So, thanks a lot for watching, and good luck to everyone, and we'll see you next time. Bye.